Hello everyone, welcome to day 28 of July Lead Code Challenge, and today's question is beautiful array. In this question we are given an array of integers where elements start from 1 up till n. We need to permutate this input array in such a way that for every ij there is no value of k where nums of k into 2 twice of nums of k happens to be equal to nums of y plus nums of j. We need to return any possible beautiful arrangement for a given size n, and let's try and understand it by an example. N equals 4, 2, 1, 4, 3 is such arrangement. There can be multiple arrangement for the same length. We need to return one such possible arrangement. The question is the most weirdest question I have ever seen. I'll talk about it during the presentation. So without much ado, let's start with the algorithm. Beautiful array, lead code 932. Let's again try and understand the question. In this question, we need to permutate all the numbers starting from n, 1 into up till n, such that for every ij, you select two indexes. There is no index k, such that nums of the element at k into 2 twice of nums of k happens to be equal to nums of y plus nums of j. And guys, for solving this, there is a pattern. I am not sure who identified this pattern at first place, but whosoever did a great job at it. And if you know what kind of pattern you need to follow, you'll be able to solve this question. If you don't know that pattern, nobody on earth can tell you that, especially in an interview. It's very difficult to come up with it. So let's start with the first size 1, where there is only one element, n is given to us as 1. What would be your answer? Since it has only one element, the answer would be 1. Let's talk about the case where n equals to 2. What you are going to do, you will start from the previously created array, nums of n minus 1, whatever array that was. And here it was a single 1, 1. So we will use this to compute our answer. We will build two arrays. One of kind odd, other of kind even, and whatever elements are there, you'll use this formula for generating the odd elements. For each element in your previously calculated array, you will create more numbers using this formula. So if you apply this formula for generating the odd length, it would be 1 into 2 minus 1, that gives you 1. And for the even length, you will simply update this to the double value, so this gets 2, and the output for n equals to 2 becomes the addition of these two, something like this, 1, 2. Let's move ahead with the iteration. Let's talk about for the case when n is equal to 3. Previously calculated array 1, 2 for n equals to 2, and we will use this to generate for the one higher than 2, n equals to 3. So what you're gonna do, you will generate two subarrays, one using the odd formula, other using the even formula. So using the odd formula, what number would be generated? 2 into 1 minus 1 is 1. 2 into 2 minus 1 is 4 minus 1, 3. So these two would be generated. And let's talk about the even case. You have 2, 4. You will skip 4 because 4 is greater than 3. So you'll not add it to the answer in the even subarray. What is the total sum of this? You have 1, 3, 2 for n equals to 3. Let's talk about the next case for n equals to 4. We'll use the previously calculated array, which is this. You'll again generate two subarrays, one using the odd formula, one using the even formula. So let's apply the odd formula to this. 2 into element minus 1 is 1. 2 into 3 is 6. 6 minus 1 is 5. 5 is greater than 4. Skip it. Let's move ahead. 2 into 2 4 is minus 1 is 3. So you'll add 3 to it. Let's talk about the even case. You have 2, 6. 6 is greater than 4. Skip it. And last one is 2 into 2 is 4. So what is the sum of this? 1, 3, 2, 4. this becomes the answer for n equals to 4. And let's talk about the next case as well, n equals to 5. Let's generate the odd length array 2 into element minus 1. So 2 into element is 1, 2 into 1 is 2, minus 1 is 1. Next we have 3 into 2 is 6, minus 1 is 5, and 5 is equal to 5. It's not greater than 5. 2 into 2 minus 1 is 3. 2 into 4 is 8, minus 1 is 7. 7 is greater than 5, skip it. Let's move ahead with the even length array. We get 2, we have 6, skip is greater than 6 is greater than 5, skip it. 4 and 8. 4 is 8 is greater than 5, we'll skip it. And we'll add these two. So the answer becomes 1, 5, 3, 2, 4. So if you know this pattern, you'll be able to solve this question. If you don't know this pattern, it's really difficult to come up with it. And you will also observe that every step, whatever subarray we are generating, even the odd length or the even length, it is becoming beautiful in nature. So it is as per the rules that we stated over here. Without much ado, let's look at the coding part. And it's also pretty straightforward to what we have just explained. The first thing that I have done here is to define my array list. And I have taken array list instead of integer primitive array, because this is dynamic in nature. As we are growing the array list, starting from the one first index up till the n index, as a default case I add 1 to it. Till the time the size of my answer array is less than n, I create a temporary list. I start the iteration from the previously calculated ans array, and if my current element, the odd element 2 into el minus 1 is less than equal to n, I add it to my temporary list. Similarly, I generate the even length array. If twice into element is less than equal to n, then only I add it into my temporary array. And as we progress ahead for the next iteration, I assign ans to the temporary array. Once I have filled in all the elements up till size of ans becomes equal to n, I abort the process out of this while loop and I dump it into an integer primitive array and I return the result. Accepted. I hope you enjoyed today's session. If you did, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for viewing it. Have a great day ahead, and don't worry guys, it seems like a very complicated question. Nobody's going to ask you this question in an interview. He'll be foolish to think that you guys have solved this question in the past and you'll be able to come up with this kind of pattern in the interview. So forget about this question. I have done this question just for the sake of completing the challenge and maintaining the consistency streak. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great day ahead. Goodbye.